Hello, Airbus cockpit coach here. You're joining me in the flight deck of the inibuilds Airbus A350, and in this video we're going to look at our cruise checks. So we've just established in the cruise, and you'll see from our OIS screen here we're just heading out through the English Channel out into the Atlantic on our way to John F. Kennedy, New York. The first thing we want to do when reaching our top of climb is to conduct a fuel check. And for this we can use our operational flight plan, a flight log, and you can use a waypoint that's nearby or one that you've just passed at our top of climb point, which we have just passed. We should have had 47.1 tonnes on board. We've currently got 50.2, so we're doing well on fuel. We want to be conducting fuel checks at least every hour, and most likely that's going to be overhead every waypoint as we head out over the Atlantic. So Recce is our next waypoint. Time elapsed at that point would be 49 minutes and just over 44 and a half tonnes. Currently got a flight time 41 minutes. If you do get discrepancies, you need to think about why you've got those discrepancies in fuel. It could be that you have an unexpectedly high headwind that was not matching the forecast, you got held on the ground longer, there's delays, or you've been vectored off by air traffic control for some reason. So we need to find reasons for why we've got discrepancies in fuel. And that's really important to do so we can understand why that is. Definitely one to keep an eye on. Obviously, always want to be mindful of there being a potential fuel leak on board. Now, the next thing we want to consider is our step climb. So we're in the cruise page here on the Perf, and we're in the cruise page. At next waypoint, we've got a step climb up to flight level 380. Want to check that that's within our optimum and also below our recommended maximum. It is, and you'll see that step climb is indicated there on the navigation display by the uptick white arrow. Once we reach that waypoint, we'll use the FCU to select the new climb altitude. We don't want to be rocketing up to that step climb altitude. We want it to be comfortable for the passengers, so you could use vertical speed at a shallow rate of 200 or 300 feet per minute. The aircraft is fitted with a auto step climb function, so if we go into options, simulation, and we have auto step climb here. So if you were going on a long haul flight and wanted to go to sleep, I want to make sure that the aircraft climbs at those points, we just simply select yes here. So that's a nice feature to have on this aircraft, very helpful. We also want to consider adjusting our TCAS. The majority of traffic is going to be below, and in the event of rapid decompressurization, we'd want that to be in below. You could have it in the normal mode, so you can take those out, but I'm going to have it in below, a preference. And the next thing we want to consider are our alternate aerodromes. So on the flight plan page, come into closest airports, we can see which ones are around us. Airports that have been planned for our ETOPS operations, we could enter those in here, and it will give us the same information: distance, time we expect to arrive there, and expected fuel on board, and we can then adjust winds for those as well, so we can factor that in. We want to be planning ahead and looking at our en route alternates using that information. And we'd also want to come over to the ATC comms menu, and if you go over to the top here, DATIS, we can select the weather for various aerodromes. So we can look at our alternate here, Philadelphia, arrival weather. So we can request that information. Update all, so we can use different airfields in here as well, so we can change the change the code for our en route alternates as well, pull that information in. Coming back to the flight plan page, and back to flight plan info at the bottom. We've also got a time option, which is quite useful, especially on long haul flights. So we can input time markers here with orbital alerts and reminder text, which is really useful. So I suppose in the real world, this could be used to alert pilots to changes in brake times. So when a pilot needs to jump out of the bunk and they alternate round on long haul flights, we could use it for that. Maybe air traffic control would say, look, contact me at time 1700, you can put that in there as a reminder, contact ATC. So as a test, we could put in, 16:51:30, enter, there we go, that's in there. That's really handy there, handy feature of the A350. And we can put up to three different times in there. And we can also put in, if you know the time difference, or we can put that in there. So if JFK was...
time marker.
There we go, there's our time marker. That's a really nice feature, very useful. If it was... So we had a minus 7 hours in JFK. It will show you the local time. And our local ETA at destination, which is really useful. We have time marker reached, we've got a message there as well. Clear that out. And in the cruise as well, we also want to be conducting regular recam checks of our systems. We're going through all the pages, looking for anything unusual, making sure fuel's nicely balanced. Looking at our quantities on the hydraulic systems. Keeping an eye on the cabin temperatures. And pressurization. Important one. Whilst many things are monitored by ECAM, they don't necessarily kick in until levels reach quite low values, for example, so it's worth keeping an eye on those, and it's good airmanship to review those regularly during the cruise. Back to the performance page and cruising there. So we've got a step climb at 16:56, which is in 29 nautical miles time, so we will climb up to 380. So those are the items that will keep us occupied during cruise. It's very much thinking ahead, looking at alternates, looking at weather, keeping up to date with air traffic control, and monitoring our step climbs performance, and of course our systems. If you have any questions on any of that, please drop them in the comments, and don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.